Hey there, so we are already in December and many of you may have several interviews, in fact even 10 plus, others may have fewer interviews or still others may be waiting, but all of you may have some questions around how to approach the rest of the match season from here on. So if you have questions about thank you cards, thank you emails, second visits, step 3 and so on, then watch on, we'll try to answer the questions in this video. First, those of you who've already been interviewing, whether it's one interview or 10, doesn't matter, you should have sent thank you emails to the programs within a day or so of the interview. While there are several templates for a thank you email, UCSF has a template which I like, and you can customize that and use it to send the thank you email. Secondly, mid-December is also a good time to consider sending thank you cards to your interviewers, the program coordinators, and others you may have met on the interview trail. Handwritten cards can be very, very useful. They need not be of an expensive variety, but it shows to the program that you took the time and effort to send that card. Of course, if the program already told you not to send any emails or card, you should respect that decision. If you've been interviewing, it's also a good time to take a step back and assess your own performance. Were you confident in those interviews? Did you face any challenging questions that you were not prepared for? It is very important to self-analyze and work on improvement areas fairly quickly, especially if you have fewer interviews. If you have less than 5 to 7 interviews, you really need to nail those interviews to get a reasonable chance for a match. Next, the question on second visits. This time of the year, we are often asked, should I go for a second visit? Is it useful? How much difference does it make, and so on. So first, many programs will offer a second look to the IMG students as well. And this is true if you're very high on their priority. They will say things like, keep us in mind when you're ranking, or you'll be a good fit for the program, so on and so forth. And then they may offer you to come back for a day to have a second look. That's always a positive sign. So consider it seriously if logistics, time, and your funding situation permit that. Now, there may be programs you're interested in, but they didn't mention anything about second visit. You can certainly ask for a second look there. However, it should have a valid reason. Maybe you could not meet the program director. Perhaps there was a faculty whose research interests aligned with yours and you could not meet him or her. So having a good reason always helps when you're pitching for a second visit. But don't despair if they don't agree. Many programs are too busy in the season to agree to all the requests. Now, what if you don't have any interviews or just 1 or 2 interviews? Can you expect more interviews? We did cover this in another video, the link to which is in the description below. But one thing you should definitely do is to be prepared. Work on your interview skills. As the programs send out interviews now on from mid-December to the end of the season, they can ask you to come at a very short notice, perhaps even at a day's notice. And these could be the cancellation interviews. Interview preparation takes time, and you don't want to miss out on an opportunity to perform well. So let's be ready. Secondly, if you don't have enough interviews, meaning you're not constantly traveling for the next couple of months, plan on working. These could be observerships, these could be hands-on experiences, or any other job. Many students who don't need visa, for example, can work as scribes. And these kind of experiences will always be helpful, even if it's unpaid at a clinic. It shows you're taking initiative and keeping yourself current in the medical knowledge. Also look for research opportunities. Research will be very, very beneficial if you need to apply next year. It can overcome low scores and many other red flags. You should plan for step 3 in December or January. For those who may not match this year, step 3 will definitely make you a better applicant next year. For others who have the interviews, it's always good to tell the program during or after the interviews that you're done with step 3. That way you can focus on the clinical training in the residency starting from day 1 without worrying about the step 3. Of course, if you need H-1B visa, that's an added incentive for you. So that was all. Tell us what you're planning to do. How are you reaching out to the programs? Are you planning to do observerships, research? What are you planning to do? So let's keep the conversation going. Share this video with your friends and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates and tips on the map. Thank you and all the best.